Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Ivan. The internet knows me as Dreamframer, and today I'm gonna show you how to upload your images for sale on Shutterstock, one of the biggest stock photography websites in the world. If you find this video useful, press that like button, leave a comment, or subscribe if you are interested in selling your photos online. The best thing about Shutterstock is that if you get accepted as a contributor, you will most likely see your first sales right after your first images get accepted. However, to become a contributor, you need to pass this little obstacle. You need to submit 10 images in your first batch, and then, if only one of those images gets accepted for sale, you will become a Shutterstock contributor. You can upload images to Shutterstock through your browser or through your FTP client. I'm gonna show you both ways, but first let's see how to do it through browser. To submit images to Shutterstock, you have to go to this URL, submit.shutterstock.com. Then go to sign up now and click it. And fill out the form, your full name, display name, email address and password. For Shutterstock, you have to certify that you are 18 years or older, and then you click next. Your display name is the name that will appear next to your photos, but you can change that later when you log into your account. So I already have an account and I'm just gonna click on login down there, and I'm gonna log into my account. If you just signed up now, you're gonna receive an email from Shutterstock. You have to confirm that email, and then they're gonna ask you to upload your ID as a proof that you are who you say you are and that you're older than 18 years of age. We are now in my dashboard, and to upload images, just click to upload in the top menu. And then you can drag and drop files here, or you can click this button and select files to upload. For Shutterstock, images have to be at least 4 megapixels big, but my advice is to keep your images at least 6.3 megapixels big, because you might want to upload your images to some other agencies in the future, and some of those agencies don't accept images smaller than 6.3 megapixels. I'm gonna click this button and select these two pictures. One of the pictures, as you can see, has a person in it. So I will have to upload this model release later. So I'm gonna click open. The images are being transferred to Shutterstock website. In the meantime, I just wanna mention that to become a contributor at Shutterstock, you will have to upload 10 images like this. And then these 10 images will go through the review. And if the reviewers accept at least one of those images, you will become a contributor. Before that, you will not be able to sell your images at all. So be sure that these 10 images are the best ones you have. When the upload is done, I'm gonna click this next button. And the website already processed my images. They already have description and keywords saved. I added description and keywords in the free app called XPix. There is a link in the description of this video where you can download this application. You can add keywords, you can change the description here. Just click in the keywords box and add, let's say, green, put comma, and Shutterstock website will save that as a new keyword. They're also giving you some suggestions here that you can click. And let's say grass background, for example. The maximum number of keywords is 50. And when you're happy with the description and keywords of all images, go to categories. You have to add the image to at least one category. Although the list of categories is limited, try to find the best matching ones. For example, for this picture would be people, and let's say maybe nature or parks outdoor. I feel like parks outdoor is more appropriate. And then you have to choose yes if this image is an illustration. Obviously this is a photo, so I'm gonna put no. And then you have to choose where you want to put Shutterstock watermark. I always leave it in the center, but if you have something in the image that is really important and it's right in the center, then you can choose to move the watermark up or down. The next box is about nudity. This image doesn't contain any nudity, obviously, so no. And this image is also not editorial. It's a commercial image. Now we have to add a model release for this image. I'm gonna choose the model release that I prepared. And here you have to type the name of the model. Choose the age from these ranges that are offered, and then choose ethnicity. I'm just gonna click other and model gender as well. I'm gonna click upload, and the model release will be saved in my saved releases over here. So later, if you have pictures with the same model, you can just pick one of your saved releases. You don't have to upload new model release over and over. And as you can see, the model release is attached to the image. Now I have to repeat the same process with the second image. And if you are applying to become a contributor at Shutterstock, you will have to do this for all 10 images in your first batch. For the first category, I chose parks, outdoor, and the best match for the second one would probably be, let's see, probably buildings and landmarks. Then check the rest of the boxes, check all the information one more time, and if you are done, select all images by clicking here and just click submit for review. Now when you know how to upload your images to Shutterstock through your browser, let me show you how to do it through FTP client. As an FTP client, I'm using a free application called XPix. This application is great for adding metadata to your images as well as uploading images to various stock photography websites. The link to download this application is posted in the description of this video. When you open XPix, click Add Files and add your images. Click Start Import to import any existing metadata. And you can see that my images already have description, keywords, and title, even though Shutterstock doesn't read titles. But if these fields are empty, you can start typing and add description, title, and keywords. Whenever you start typing a new keyword, XPix will give you suggestions. To divide keywords, you have to click comma on your keyboard. If you can't come up with enough keywords, XPix has this great function of suggesting you keywords from popular stock websites like Shutterstock. To show you this, I cleared this keyword field and I'm gonna click suggest. You can see that Shutterstock is already chosen in the right up corner of this window, and I'm gonna click here and type boy dandelion to find images similar to mine on Shutterstock. And I'm gonna click on a few of those images, and XPix will add keywords from these images to this field here. Other keywords that are not the same for all these images are gonna be put in the lower box where it says other keywords. So far, XPix chose 45 keywords for me, and I can add more of those by clicking this plus sign in the lower box. Just be careful not to add any spammy keywords. So check the upper box for any words that are not relevant for this picture and take them out. Now when I'm happy with all the metadata, I want to upload these images, but first I'm gonna get the warning that I have to save them. So I'm gonna click OK here, click Save, and click Start Export. Now I can upload them. In this window here, I already saved all the websites where I'm submitting my photos. To add a new website like Shutterstock, for example, you have to fill out these fields over here. So click add FTP host and fill out the fields on the right. You can give any title to the title field. In our example, this is Shutterstock. As a host, type ftp.shutterstock.com. Username is your email address registered at Shutterstock, and the password is your password for Shutterstock. Then you click Start Upload and your images will be transferred to Shutterstock. You need to give some time to the website to process your images. It usually takes about an hour, sometimes less than that, sometimes more. But once the processing is done, you can log into your Shutterstock account, click on Portfolio, Submit Images, and you will see your images ready to be submitted just like before. Just add categories, check other boxes, fix the description and keywords if needed, and submit your images for the review. After this, you can only wait for the email from Shutterstock to inform you about the results of the review. If you like this video, press that like button, leave a comment, ask me a question, and subscribe if you still didn't. The next video will be about uploading images to Dreamstime, which is another big stock photography website. And happy selling on Shutterstock. Bye.